Here is an outline of my talk, a brief historical framework about the sciences of complexity, how they developed in other fields, and how nonlinearity and complexity were addressed in architecture from different points of view, and which is the role played by complexity today in the area of architecture, some criticism to the so-called complex architecture, and an attempt to propose a more balanced position which also aims at fulfilling the ethical problems which are in the background of this symposium. Okay, during the second half of the 20th century, following Poincaré intuitions, fundamentals of science of nonlinear and complex systems were developed and brought to maturity mainly within the physical mathematical community, starting from Poincaré. It was the origin of chaos theory, the birth of algebraic topology, and here there are a number of names and the main topics developed within the area of so-called nonlinear dynamics in the second half of 20th century, including catastrophe theory, complexity, chaos theory, fractal theory, and so on. In turn, in the two or three last decades, I would say the two last decades of the past century, great research effort was devoted to highlighting the significance of nonlinearity and complexity concepts and phenomena in most physical, biochemical, natural, and engineered systems. And here you can see a number of areas in which notions, concepts, and tools from dynamical systems theory have been applied for application purposes. For instance, as regards structural and mechanical engineering, a number of theoretical problems have been addressed both in the statical environment and in the dynamical environment. For instance, in the statical environment, dealing with the buckling problem of a column with a supercritical behavior after buckling, the collapse of an arch problem is natural phenomenon, whereas in the dynamic areas the so-called problem of the escape from a potential well, which governs the equilibrium of a body, and from the practical point of view this governs, for instance, the ship's stability and the possible capsize of a ship due to the exchange of energy between the so-called rolling motion and the pitch motion and the rolling motion, which can lead to capsize. Here there are a couple of videos. Of course, all of you maybe knows this one, the Tacoma Bridge failure, which is due to the exchange of energy between flexural and torsional modes, which is a typical phenomenon, nonlinear phenomenon playing an important role for structures. In the slide below, there is a video concerned with the synchronization phenomenon in the Millennium Bridge that all of you knows, but unfortunately doesn't work. If I click on that, everything will disappear, so I cannot do it. Okay, let's go back here. There has been also a strong popularization of the concept and tools of nonlinearity and chaos, starting with the book, nice popular book by James Blake at the beginning of the 90s, up to this more scientific book, one on the right from Thompson and others, and so all these issues became popular also in areas like economics, social sciences, and architecture. What happened happens in architecture. Starting with the late 80s, more or less, with the constructive movement based on the ideas from some French philosophers, became popular in the area. Oh, okay, this is wrong. This is completely wrong, sorry. This is completely wrong, and I have to go back out, open this way, okay. And a number of concepts, including fragmentation, manipulation of surface or skin ideas, non-rectilinear shapes, distortion and dislocation of elements of architecture, and so on, started to govern a number of design projects by many archistars. Some of them are listed therein. Generally speaking, a new paradigm in architecture has been developed, more or less starting with works by Charles Jenks. Here is written 2003, but actually the matter was addressed much earlier in the beginning of the 90s. And Jenks says that based on complexity concepts, a number of complexity concepts, nonlinear architecture has been developed, and according to him, nonlinear architecture will prosper, he said times ago, as a major movement into the new millennium fed by the new sciences of complexity. And he wondered how much do architects understand of fractals, emergence theory, folding, nonlinearity, self-organizing systems, which are a number of issues of interest for people involved in nonlinear dynamics world. But according to him, according to Jenks, the most important point is why does it matter? And he claims that there are actually two complexity theories, one in the architectural area and the other one in the scientific area, independent from each other. Of course, there was an immediate reaction from people working in a more strict mathematical field, basically Nikos Salingeros, who claims that no understanding or use of nonlinear and complex concepts can be actually recognized in the constructive realization. The cult intentionally ignores scientific meaning, and there is a kind, according to Salingeros, a kind of mystical cult that uses scientific terminology just like magical words, and architects uses words like chaos, nonlinear systems, complexity, without having any idea of what these things actually mean. So this is the background, and I wondered, together with my PhD student, which links there are, if any, about the two worlds which seems to go ahead independently from each other. So now in a number of slides I will go quite fast examining the two perspectives, the scientific perspective against the architectural perspective. For instance, in terms of fractal architecture, there are mainly three main categories corresponding to three different ways in which architects have taken the concept of fractal. One is the concept of fractal design. These are a number of fundamental objects. The one on the right, the so-called Henon attractors and the Sierpinski triangle, are two main basical objects from dynamical systems theory used by mathematicians, by engineers in various fields and so on. Architects have appropriated these concepts and reproduced in some of their works, as you can see on the left side, these objects taken from the mathematical environment, mainly as a purely figurative and formal inspiration.